We are back and better than ever. It's a brand new year, and surely this year cannot be stupider than the last year. Yeah, so about that. So many things have happened while I was out. Aside from my children badgering me, and aside from me not getting enough sleep as I should have over the break, it turns out many stupid things happened over the course of the break. Perhaps the stupidest was this thing that happened in Congress yesterday. I'm just going to mention this briefly because it is indicative of where this year is going, and then we'll get to the actual big news stories of the day. So yesterday, Congress opened with a prayer. The prayer with which Congress opened is, I believe, the stupidest thing I have ever heard in all my life. In all my life, and I've heard many stupid things. I mean, I literally do a political talk show, so I hear stupid things on a daily basis. So yesterday, the person who opens with the opening prayer, Democratic Congress, obviously, opens by saying this.
We ask it in the name of the monotheistic God, Brahma, and God known by many names, by many different faiths. A man and a woman.
So just to be straight, this human said, amen and a women. And now, as the designated Jew in your political life, let me just remind you, as a Hebrew speaker, the word amen is not an English word. It comes from the Hebrew word, amen, which you say after prayers, which can originally be traced, etymologically speaking, to the word emet, which means truth. The idea of amen is solidarity, and may it be so, or it's true, that's what amen means. It was then brought into Greek and Latin, and then passed along to English. The word amen has literally nothing to do with gender. It does not mean a man. It means amen. In other words, it is a sign. It's like hallelujah, right? It's a sign of solidarity, right? That's what it is. It's an exclamation. And yet somehow, leftists have decided that the term amen, because it is spelled A-M-E-N and includes the word men, somehow is gendered language. And so we are also supposed to say after prayers, a women. So a few things. Number one, not only is that radically stupid on an etymological level, I mean, you would have to take the word amen, take it down to the pit of despair from the Princess Bride, put the torture machine on it, and torture it until it tosses out some sort of gendered variant. Not only is that stupid on that level, it would also then be meaningless. Why would you end a prayer, any prayer, and then just say, man? Like, what? That doesn't make any sense at all. It's idiotic. Beyond that, it's doubly idiotic because it turns out that people on the left don't actually believe that men and women are real concepts, right? They're malleable, men and women. So what they really should say, just to be tolerant, is not amen and a women. They should say amen, a women, and a gender is a social construct that is unconnected to biological sex, but also a biological imperative, and then bow their heads. That's where that should end. So well done all the way through, everybody. That's a great way to start the year. And I think that the year can only get dumber from here, unfortunately. Okay, so.